All right, and welcome back to the Concert Artists Guild Finals of 2018. We are going up next with Dmitry Nilov, percussionist, accompanied by Asia Korepanova, piano. They have a fascinating program of Séjourné, Gerasimech, and Jefkovic for you. Really, I just can't wait for you to hear it, honestly. Toy, toy, toy.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please remember to turn off your cell phones as you enter. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Berkeley Concert Hall. Our next performer is Dmitry Nilov.
Good morning, everyone. We are overjoyed to be performing for you this morning. Our program consists out of three pieces by European composers. The first piece on the program is Séjourné Concerto. We're going to perform two contrasting movements from a lovely concerto that was written by a contemporary French composer, Emmanuel Séjourné. I have a personal connection to this piece because it's the very first piece I performed with an orchestra in the United States a few years ago. The second piece on the program is written for the vibraphone and piano, and it is a celebration of music by Astor Piazzolla. It was written by a young composer whose name is Alexei Gerasimets, and it is highly influenced by the musical textures that all the New Yorkers are familiar with. Those are of Chick Corea and Gary Bird. The third piece on the program is a short, bright piece written by a Serbian-born composer, Nebojša Jovanđivkin, and it is written for an African drum called Djembe. Thank you for coming today. This is Sergio Memory. share something with you. You know, I've been lately thinking of a phrase that we all hear every day, that music brings hope. And it's a beautiful phrase that we see everywhere, but we don't really think about what it means. In addition to a huge responsibility that any musician would have, we don't often remember how privileged we are, that we are a part of an art form that brings people hope in this contemporary world full of injustice and underprivilege. I'm happy that I'm making music, and I thank you for coming today and for making moments like this possible. And here's to the gas green.
Dmitry Nilov there on percussion. Dmitry says that he reminds himself how happy he is every time he makes music, and that all he needs to do when he walks out on stage is to enjoy every moment and play his heart out. Now, he certainly heard that. He says life as a percussionist never gets boring, and he has performed throughout Europe and the USA as an advocate for new music, as we heard there. Up next, we have John Henry Crawford on the cello, accompanied by Luis Ortiz on the piano. He has an interesting program of Sanford, Boulanger, and Strauss for us, and has performed recitals in Paris, Germany, and Russia. Now, I asked John Henry what he says to himself before he goes on stage, and he described himself as a sucker for inspirational quotations. And this one by Marcus Aurelius gives him a little bit of inspiration. You have power over your mind, not outside events. Realize this, and you will find strength. They're great words to listen to. John Henry also advises you listeners to listen out in the 7th Avenue Kaddish by David Sanford for the ambulances and sirens scattered throughout that piece there. John Henry was also the first prize winner of the Greenfield Concerto Competition and is now completing his master's degree at the Juilliard School and is a graduate of the Curtis Institute of Music. As we are clearing the stage here, I'm going to share a little bit more now with you from our jury, what they particularly listen out for in audition and competition situations. One of our jurors has said, I like to look for what I call an energetic footprint. How much energetic space does he or she fill? Soloists especially need to have a certain charisma in addition to having superb technical and artistic gifts. It's not about being extroverted or flamboyant. There are quiet ways to be powerful on stage as well. It's about the footprint. I love that. It's great advice there that we have from our jury. What else? I want to give you something that is useful to you as you're preparing for your own auditions. Here are some words from Lisa Bilowa. Love every stage of the process. enjoy practicing, rehearsing, relaxing in the downtime, the butterflies, all of it. This is your life. And if you are dedicated and fortunate enough, you will have many years of preparing for things ahead of you. So embrace it. Absolutely. Yes, embrace it. Do you know what? It's hard to embrace the butterflies sometimes, as I can remember from being backstage here in many years ago. And I'm going to continue talking here as we chat away. John Henry, do you want to have a little interview? Yeah? Put you on the spot? He's like, nah, he's in the zone. Yeah? Would you like to tell us a little bit about the first piece that you're going to play?
Sure. Well, I'll just repeat what I'm about to say on stage. But the the first piece by David Sanford was written from the point of view of a street musician on 7th Avenue playing near Ground Zero on 9/11. And overwhelmed by panic and confusion, this street musician doesn't know what else to do other than to soldier on and continue playing as a kind of professional mourner or griever. And after a flurry of what seems like never-ending chaos, it finally ends in a quiet lament, hence the name 7th Avenue Kaddish.
Absolutely. Fantastic. Well, thank you for that introduction. You also, I know, have a big Instagram following, and you're doing something. What is it? Is it 10,000 days of... 1,000 days of practice. Yeah, I couldn't remember. Many zeros, I thought. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, basically every day I record a little clip of what I'm working on and post it out there for people to see, and people seem to be enjoying it for now.
Where could we find that? What hashtag is that?
At Cello Crawford on Instagram. Yeah.
Wonderful. Okay. Toy, and thank you for interviewing. You're fabulous. Here we have John Henry Crawford on the cello, accompanied by Luis Ortiz on the piano.
John Henry Crawford. After what seems like a never-ending flurry of chaos, the piece ends in a kind of quiet lament, hence the name of 7th Avenue Kaddish. Nadia Boulanger, arguably one of the most influential women in composition, taught figures like Aaron Copland, Astor Piazzolla, Daniel Barenboim, Philip Glass, and studied herself with Maurice Ravel. This piece has a very Ravelian kind of aspect to it. Kind of a singing contrapuntal style with lots of atmosphere. And then finally, we will end with Strauss's heroic cello sonata, which he wrote when he was just 19 years old. It predates his pieces like Don Quixote and Till Eulenspiegel, but we still can't help but imagine he's dreaming of these pieces in this sonata as well. Thank you again for being here. Here's the 7th Avenue Kaddish.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
John Henry Crawford there on the cello, accompanied by Louise Ortiz on the piano. Up next, we have Xi'an Wang, UK-based pianist who has a special interest in the music of Franz Liszt and Ferruccio Busoni. He's already been awarded first prize for his critically acclaimed debut album, Liszt Transfigured, Operatic Fantasies for Piano. All you people, get on Amazon, order it now. You heard it here first. I asked Xi'an what he likes to tell himself before he goes on stage. And he says, do you know, no advice for myself at all. Everything's possible in a performance. I live and embrace that seemingly coincidental moment. But hey, there are no coincidences. Or are there? He began learning the piano at age 3 and then lessons at age 6. He says, though, he realizes, though, that he starts to learn his instrument afresh every day. Here we have Xi'an Wang.
Finally on the soil of this beautiful country. So exciting that I need a piece of paper with a beautiful, with a very youthful and, shall I say, energetic history. I would like to express my gratitude through music, probably is better, with Busoni's enchanting setting of two Native American Indian folk melodies. They are the Corn Harvesting Hymn and the Song of the Bluebird. So these two figures, Busoni, as well as Franz Liszt, have been revenant-like figures throughout my life, guiding me from an early age. To me, they're not merely astounding virtuosis of this magical instrument, but they also love fantastic tales from far away in distant lands and cultures. For me, from the bold, hypnotic melodies of the Pima and Laguna Indians, to the cinematic scope of Dante's Divine Comedy, this very instrument becomes Aladdin's lamp. It bridges the gap between reality and illusion. Thank you for listening. Let us begin.
Thank you.
Tian Wang there on the piano. And coming up next, we have a vocal ensemble for you by the name of Ciela. So these six singers joined forces many moons ago and continue to discover new ways to diversify their sound. They are based in Leipzig, Germany, and another album, lads, to add to your shelves, Meridian Nord, will be released in the fall of 2018. I asked them, what do you do before you go on stage? And I've just seen them do it. They form a close circle, give each one a hug and a kiss, and motivate each other. It gives them a sense of power and a feeling of being connected. They have a fantastic program for you of music from Northern Europe in different facets, and they invite you to find your own favorite moment. Can you hear them warming up here through the microphone? They are just fabulous. Because they are singers, they started with their first cry on earth, and most of them started singing in a children's choir at the age of 4 to 6. Our jury member, Lisa Bilowa, says that with ensembles, she listens and looks for group think. It is magical to witness, she says, communication between truly compatible musical souls on stage. I'm excited for you guys to hear them. Here we have the Ciela Vocal Ensemble from Germany.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next performers are Ciela.
Ave Genero. morning. We are Sienna from Leipzig in Germany, and it's a great pleasure and honor to stand on the stage today. As a group, we feel connected to very different musical genres, but especially to the music from Northern Europe. This is not just because our name is a Swedish word for soul, but also our affection for this particularly pure sound the music of Northern Europe has. So today we would like to focus on that kind of music. Now we would like to go from a well-known Norwegian composer, contemporary composer, to a piece written in the English Baroque era, Music for a While by Henry Purcell.
Dum 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 d
humoristic song written in the 70s by the American singer and songwriter Mike Cross. Nowadays, it is actually considered to be an Irish drinking song that tries to solve the mystery about Scottish fashion, especially the wearing of, or let's say, beneath kilts.
Yeah.
national epic called Kalevala and tell a story of a woman who hears her beloved's voice in the wind. She's really longing for him because he's far away from her. But after a long time, he finally returns. And she describes her love for him, yeah, like with Finnish humor, saying that it feels like a squirrel hanging on a fir branch. Thanks for having us here today and enjoy Uli.
Thank you.
vocal ensemble Ciela there. Fabulous, bravi. All right, that brings us to the end of our second section. Join us back after lunch at 2:30 p.m. Now, a little word again from our jury members for any of you young hopefuls out there. We asked Shay Wozner what he thought that he listened out for, particularly in auditions and competition situations, and this is what he said. I think being on a jury isn't really that different from being an enthusiastic concert goer. You want to be inspired by the performers and be made to follow their thinking and their take on a piece from beginning to end. When someone truly has the audience in their grip and you sense that everyone in the room is tuned in to the performer's train of thought and emotions, as if something has changed in the magnetic field surrounding the hall, it tells you all you need to know about an artist. Wise words there, good things for us to grab onto and use in our own performances and practice rooms all across the world. We're seeing that you're tuning in from all across Europe, from Asia, from here in the US, and we're delighted to have you with us. We're here at the Merkin Concert Hall. We're a short 10 blocks away from Carnegie Hall, and that is indeed one of the grand prizes that will be awarded to some of our lucky finalists today, to have a recital presented by the Concert Artists Guild at Carnegie Hall's Weill Hall. It's one of the special prizes, along with performance opportunities around the country here, along with recording opportunities. It's pretty remarkable what Concert Artists Guild do. I won their competition in 2011, and I have to say it's like being a part of a great big family. And once you're in there for life, kind of. So we hope that you join us back again at 2:30. In the meantime, do tweet at us. Let us know what you're thinking. Let us know if you have any questions for our esteemed jury at CAG, hashtag CAGComp2018. Join us back here again at 2:30.